Hello, my name is Care, and welcome to the From 9 to 5 to Entrepreneur vlog, where we talk about what it's like to go from a 9 to 5 to the entrepreneur life. And today, I'm actually really tired right now. I've been lying on the couch just chilling now and like going through my little like daily social media scrolls, and I was feeling really motivated and inspired, and then I went to YouTube and I decided to take a look at like my old YouTube videos from 9 years ago, and I was just like, very interesting. 9 years ago, I was also in the same spot where I was searching for a job, and I say that because it has been an amazing journey going from 9 to 5 to entrepreneur, but I realized that I took a big ass leap, and I had savings, but the savings came out, and as soon as the savings came out, I used all the savings to help me pay off some credit cards, some bills, my mortgage, and buy myself some groceries, and then it was poof, gone. So I am realizing now that I am under a lot of pressure. I feel pressured to make a lot of income, and I haven't seen enough income come through my business. So I've thrown in the towel and I've said, you know what, let's go back to the whole, not 9 to 5 thing, but let's go back to getting a job, and we're gonna try it again. And this time we're gonna get a job, and we're gonna make sure that we make income in our job, but also make sure that we're working on our business so that our business is able to make at least the same income or more than our full-time job, and then that's when we can take another leap. So I don't know when that's gonna happen. I am projecting that's gonna happen in about 5 years, and you know what, I'm totally okay with that. I applied for a remote job earlier today, and I'm looking forward to hearing the results. And right now, I'm also slowly chipping away at this delicious oatmeal filled with protein and some honey. I have been eating a lot of like oatmeal recently because I realized that in order to manifest like anything that would make you feel full, so for example, like abundance, money, wealth, whatever it is, clients, business, you gotta feel full on your own. You gotta already feel full, because it's actually the emotions that you feel that bring in those things that relate to those emotions, right? So I was just like, okay, what's something that I can do to help me feel full? And I was just like, let's eat oatmeal. It's very nourishing. I feel nourished. It's so good. I feel nourished and I feel full when I eat it. And the really cool thing about eating like a full meal is that when you start to get full, you know, your body starts to metabolize, starts to work on metabolizing that food. And what happens is your body's so focused on doing that that it can't focus anymore on the overthinking that's happening up here. So it actually helps to relieve anxiety and stress. And I think that might be why a lot of us reach out to food when we're stressed, right? Because literally eating food helps us relieve stress because we're getting full in it and we're focusing on the food. I actually made some lunch today and I ate like half of it. I wasn't really hungry. I was so focused on like doing other things, but my mind and my like heart just kept saying like, eat some oatmeal. So I'm doing that right now. And it was a really long day. I spent about
I think about 3 or 4 hours on a job application. And I think it's really cool because nowadays, like, I noticed that job applications are so much more different than they were before. Like, before, you would just upload your cover letter and your resume for a job. But now there are forms out there where you can fill out, like, a type form, for example. And in that type form, they can ask you for all these details, like your name. They can test you on what you would be doing on the job. They can test your abilities. They can also ask for other information like your internet speed or your typing speed if it's like a remote job, right? They can test your technical aptitude. So they can test pretty much like almost all of your skills. And you can also just kind of like upload a video of yourself now so that they can see you and also get an answer from you for like a specific interview question, for example. And I think it's just really cool. And it also just helps me understand what my clients are working with today, because I do help clients too with career manifestations. And so every time when I mentored like other clients, they would tell me about all these like different services online where they could tweak their resume, upload their resume, or like send their resume from. And I was like, huh, what is this service that is so cool? And I would go and check it out. That is the sound of my laundry. I was washing my shoes because I like to take my shoes to the gym, but I also like to wear these shoes like indoors. And I'm also drying a towel and like a mask in there, I think. So that is done now. That is the sound of it being done. So I'm going to take that out before I go to bed. But I just wanted to give you a quick update on the whole 9-to-5 entrepreneur journey here. It's not that I've given up on entrepreneurship. I actually decided that I'm in a space where I also want to develop my skills in coaching. So I am looking at jobs that have to do with coaching. And so I'm aligning with that. And I'm also sticking with my own values, like for working, making sure that it's remote, making sure that it's as flexible as possible, making sure that it helps me also get the life that I want. So time freedom and location freedom is important to me. And also just like freedom to do whatever I want. In general, but also be able to like help people all over the globe. And I've also adjusted the hours of my business as well. So the other day I was hanging out with another coach friend. I actually met her for the first time in person. I met her online and she lives in Vancouver. I live in Calgary. And it was really cool to meet her because we were like just hitting it off like so easily. And during my chat with her, I had an epiphany that I could really hold space for people late at night. Like I could hold space after, I think it was like after 10 p.m. or something, and people were just telling me some stuff and this friend was sharing some stuff with me. And then I was just like holding space. I was like reflecting back what she was saying. And she was telling me like she really likes how I can kind of like, you know, like put all this information together. And I was like, you just made me realize that I think I actually am better at coaching in the evening, especially when it comes to like voice or video or like in person. And we were in a car in that time, so that was in person. And I realized that maybe that's exactly where my niche is and where my authentic, like, where the authenticity of my business is like coaching people who match up to the 7 p.m. to like 11 p.m. time for me. But for them, maybe it's like 12 noon for them. So I adjusted my business hours to include evening hours. And I also reduce some of the morning hours in my business as well, so I can accommodate for the time difference and the time change. And I'm excited to see how that will unfold. And I think that works out pretty well, because then it creates a space for me to get back into a full-time job. And yeah, that's all the updates that I have for today. So that's where I'm at right now. And I don't remember if I mentioned this before, but I did intend to take a career sabbatical, or career break, as they call it, for at least 6 months. And it has been past the 6 month mark. I quit my full-time job back in October 2021. It is now April 2022. So I think it has just been over 6 months, October. Let's see, November, December, January, February, March, April. So yeah, at the end of this April, it'll be exactly 6 months. So when I set intentions out there, the universe really, really hears me and listens to me and gives me exactly what I intend. So it's good that I've been taking the 6 month like break, but at the same time, it's a little bit of a struggle. I'm not gonna lie, it's a little bit of a struggle, because I have been wanting to just work through the whole thing, and I realized that I set an intention to have a break, and so I'm just trying to just enjoy as much of a break as I can, but at the same time, bring income in, because that is important, and that'll help me sustain this this entrepreneur life. While I'm unraveling this and figuring this out and searching for my next clients. So anyway, I just wanted to let you know that. Thank you all so much for watching and for listening. Let me know in the comments below if any of this resonated with you, and if there's anything you would like to specifically see on the From 9 to 5 to Entrepreneur vlog. I will do my best to film something related to it and upload it to YouTube, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Love you all.